Belinda presents this unabridged recording of the Joyful Startup Guide. Now is the time to make your startup dreams come true. Written and read by Serina Bird. To my husband, Neil, who edits all my podcasts and grounds me when I'm carried away with big ideas that I have no idea how to implement. And to anyone who has ever dared to bring a dream to reality. Foreword by Avril Henry. What an absolute delight this book by Serina Bird is. Like Serina herself, the book is full of tips, good advice, wisdom and humour shared in a simple and uncomplicated way with a great dose of generosity. What I love about Serina, and it shines through this book in bucket loads, is that she is so optimistic and a realist. She is passionate and a dreamer. She is visionary while always being practical and realistic. She is a change agent, yet never overcome by failures or challenges. She picks herself up and tries again and again until she succeeds. She has the heart of a lioness, a strong work ethic, compassion, and a deep commitment to helping others in life and in succeeding. If you are ready to pursue your dream of being an entrepreneur, self-employed, and living your best life, then this is the book for you. This book is like unlocking a treasure box of checklists, tips, tools, and advice from someone who has been there and succeeded and failed and always believed in the possibility of her dreams and ideas, at times terrified but always stronger in her self-belief than her fear. The book is practical and flows from one logical process to the next. It is the perfect step-by-step manual on how to start up your own business. I wished something like this had existed when I started my own business in 2003. It would have made starting a business as a single mum who gave up a highly paid corporate job much easier and far less stressful. In this book, Serina effortlessly moves through the different stages of a startup business with sound advice about what to do, what to watch out for, and even what to avoid. My favourite parts of each chapter are the thoughtful, insightful questions and practical exercises to stimulate your own thinking about what you truly want for your business, your values, objectives, goals, aspirations, and outputs. Follow this advice and answer each of these questions truthfully, and you cannot possibly go wrong. This book is an invitation to follow your dreams of being an entrepreneur, your own boss, owning your own business, doing work you love that feeds your soul, nourishes your heart, expands your thinking and creates the blueprint for living your best life, not anyone else's. Accept the invitation and, as Serina advises, don't wait until things are perfect. Enjoy the journey. Avril Henry, founder, Avril Henry and Associates. Foreword by Diane Phillips. Hello, my name is Diane Phillips. I'm a senior lecturer in entrepreneurship and innovation at the University of Canberra, Australia. My own journey has involved startups and exit strategies, and I now see myself as an innovator and intrapreneur in the university I work for. I met Serina through our local Canberra Innovation Network events, such as the Canberra Female Founder Series. Inspired by Serina and her network, the Female Founders events are all about passion and purpose, and participants' discussion is purpose-driven towards social impact through innovation and entrepreneurship, plus the power of collaborating and networking with women-led businesses throughout the Australian Capital Territory and beyond. Having gotten to know Serina, it's hardly surprising that her second book, The Joyful Startup Guide, has come to fruition to support up-and-coming entrepreneurs. Serina's passion and enthusiasm come through in everything she does. You will see this in the book as Serina, a storyteller, shares her knowledge, skills, and wisdom as she continues to grow in her own innovative and entrepreneurial journey, learning and growing through every aspect of business life. The 10 chapters of the book cover the preliminary steps before you jump ship to the basics of getting started in your business, such as planning and branding, building trust, and networking. joining the startup slash business ecosystem, basics of finance, productivity, co-production and teamwork, and the final chapter, ready, set, launch. Providing the listener with a broad overview, what to do and tips from her experience to smooth the way for future entrepreneurs, Serina herself and the book explore and demonstrate the energy, enthusiasm, and hard work needed to get a startup to market. Another important aspect of the book is that Serina is honest and transparent as she demonstrates her ability to learn, fail, and fall, and shows the steps to bounce back up with resilience and as a stronger business person. With grace and substance, Serina shows her growth in leadership, knowledge, and great determination to succeed, all important attributes for startup ventures. Serina has a focus on women in business, reminding me of some of my own experiences mentoring women who want to be in business and have a strong desire to be independent. The main element for me has been to support them in terms of confidence in their own vision and business understanding, whilst managing a family and job and planning their future dreams in a common sense way that the book does. The Joyful Startup Guide provides strategies, responses and actions to alleviate the challenges slash obstacles slash roadblocks that women face when starting up their entrepreneurial ventures as women in business. In addition, Serina's book looks to reduce the invisibility of women as entrepreneurs, sharing success stories and providing role models for future female entrepreneurs. Serina's joyful brand, her books, podcasts, and courses not only enable others to dream big and follow their dreams, but also inspire Serina herself to continue on her journey as a writer, podcaster, and innovator. Diane Phillips, Senior Lecturer, University of Canberra, Program Director for the Suite of Bachelor of Business Degrees, Chair of the Canberra Business School Seminar Series. Introduction. Warning, this book may make you quit your job or do something radical. I don't mean to encourage people, especially women, to quit their jobs in the search of living a life aligned with their true purpose. But I tend to have that effect on people, and I'm not sorry. This is not a book about how to grow a six-figure business in a week. I do have a fabulous entrepreneur friend who successfully started a new business with a $100,000 contract, and others who are doing even better. But I'm still in the startup phase, still finding my groove, and not yet attracting rivers of gold for my ideas. I am, however, manifesting it to come. I have big dreams, and already I'm seeing the proof that it is happening. This book shares some of my newbie learnings to help others as they flow and grow into doing what they feel soul called to do. My story. Just over 2 years ago from writing this, I quit my diplomatic career. I didn't just take leave without pay and I didn't take long service leave. I just quit. It is almost unheard of for people to do that. In China, they often refer to public service careers as the iron rice bowl, Tie Fan Wan. It's an income that is unbreakable. The reality is that changes, mergers and redundancies do occur, but for a mum with two young kids to support, it's a stable and secure choice. My decision to leave work was to a large extent forced by my being in a difficult and toxic work section. It can happen anywhere. I'm not about to criticise my former department, and in fact, I later went back to work there. I talk more about this in Chapter 7. I am arguably more sensitive to conflict and stress than many others due to some lingering PTSD from my first marriage. Leaving work when I did provided me with an amazing opportunity to heal and grow and to lean into doing what I love. Simply put, it was time. On fire. My decision to leave work was influenced by the financial independence, retire early, FIRE movement. When I started writing about saving and investing in my book, The Joyful Frugalista, I wasn't consciously part of FIRE. I had even said publicly that I wasn't FIRE. I enjoyed my job, was good at it, even though I didn't think so at the time, and dreamt of having a dual writing public service career while being fabulously wealthy. The FIRE movement co-opted me. I began to read about and meet with some amazing people in the FIRE community. What I love about the movement is that financial security and independence shows how people can live life on their terms and do what they want. YOLO, you only live once. People on FIRE say no to conventionality and do what they want to do. A week after the toxicity at work hit a pinnacle, and while I was still beating myself up about not being thick-skinned enough, I went to Sydney and participated in a panel discussion after the screening of Playing with Fire, hosted by share trading platform Perla. As I watched the first-person story of a couple who decided to quit their jobs and pursue financial independence, a little voice inside of me whispered, "Why don't you do that too? What use is money in the bank if you can't use it to make your dreams come true?" By this stage in my life, I had remarried my super supportive husband, Neil. Neil had spent over 30 years working in the public service and had strong work security and great super. I also had good super. The home mortgage was almost paid off. We had investment properties. We owned our car outright and had no personal debt. I didn't quite fit the profile of most people who hit FIRE, but I was close enough that I could take a risk. In a way, it might have been easier and perhaps more conventional if I had decided to retire rather than go into business land. In the early days, it might even have been cheaper and certainly safer. But I'd always been that person who dreamed of being in business. I love innovation and always found myself scribbling random business ideas into the back of diaries or notebooks. Anything I could write on, really. I was an out-of-the-box thinker. But in my public service land, the thinking was, of necessity, so risk-averse, it was like working in a secret box within a locked box. My business model goes bung. Before I left, I had a simple and I thought effective business model, become famous and earn lots of money. It's easy to laugh at that, but there was some truth to this. I was getting a fair bit of media following the publication of The Joyful Frugalista, had 4 freelance writing arrangements and had launched a podcast with a friend that was tracking well. I planned to work with that friend to develop other ideas, one of which eventually formed the genesis for The Joyful Business Club. I discussed partnership pitfalls in Chapter 8. For the first few weeks, things did well. I picked up a new freelance writing arrangement, worked on promoting the podcast, and spoke at various events. Then things changed. The first was the bushfires, which started 3 weeks after I quit. With Canberra blanketed in toxic smoke haze for months, I was mostly trapped indoors with my kids. It wasn't the best environment for writing mojo, although it did motivate me to start writing about giving away items in a challenge I termed joyful giving. Then the podcasting partnership busted up at the end of my first post-work month. I hadn't predicted it, but with the benefit of hindsight, I knew I should have. At the time, I was devastated, as a large part of my post-work business model was going to be fleshing out some of my ideas with someone I thought was a close friend and business partner. Now it was all kaput. But setback is an opportunity for growth. And after encouragement from friends, special shout out here to my big sister friend Trish Smith and the lovely Erna Glassford, aka at Simply Cheeky, I had the courage to launch a solo podcast in early March with my husband Neil as producer. In mid-March, COVID started to bite and podcasts trended. 2 weeks after launch, the Joyful Frugalista podcast was featured in the Canberra Times. It's since been profiled in New Idea as one of 3 top finance podcasts and has also been highlighted in Money Magazine. I love, love, love being a podcast host, and I learned so much from sharing the wisdom of my amazing...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.